Hello, what's up today? In this video, I want to show you how you can get the best out of your Facebook advertisement even with your tight budget. As you can see, Facebook ad is very competitive as at the moment. If you open your Facebook, you see ads everywhere, and that means a lot of people are becoming aware of online business, so that if you run ad, it is very competitive. If you don't have a strong strategy in place, nobody will subscribe to your lead or buy your product. And so you need a very strong strategy in place to be able to scale through out of those ads. Now, there is, for a couple of days now, there's a strategy I've been using, and it is working for me perfectly. And I'm going to show you how this method work. Now, the first thing you are going to do is to create an engagement ad. And in this engagement ad you are going to create, you are going to select video views. You will create a video, and this video you are going to create, you will just be lecturing on the product you are selling. Don't even prove that you are selling a product, just lecture them for free. Just take an aspect of the product and just create a kind of awareness. You are just educating the public. You are just educating the public on your product. After you have created that video, when you are creating that ad, you are going to upload that video, and you are not going to tell them that you are selling anything yet. Just lecture them for free. Take for instance, you are into property. You can just pick a topic. Maybe you are into real estate business. You can pick a topic like disadvantage and advantages of buying a property, or advantages and disadvantages of renting a house. So if you pick that topic, you will just lecture the public for free. You are not telling them you are selling anything, just lecture them for free. Now, when you lecture them, people that are interested in real estate, people that are really interested in real estate, will click on that video and watch it, maybe to 75%, or even watch it to the end. Then, after you have run that video ads, then you will now create a custom audience, of people that have watched the video, maybe something like True Play. You can create a custom audience of people that have watched the video, all the people that have watched the video, or you create a custom audience of the people that have watched the video to maybe 50% or 25% or even 75%, depends on your budget. If your budget is not much, then you can select all the people that have watched the video. Or if you have enough budget, then you can select, you can run ad wider and select people that have watched the video to 75%. Now, if your budget is tight, then you may not select the whole of Nigeria. Depends on the product you are selling. You may not have to select the whole of Nigeria or select the whole of the world. Before you should select the whole of Nigeria. That means you must have enough budget. If your budget is tight, then what you do is don't select the whole of Nigeria, just select the city you are in. And even the city you are in, you may not target the whole of that city, just target a radius. Now take for instance, if I hit continue, then you will give your ad a name, let's say test, then you will select your budget, let's say $5. Let the budget be small, then you hit continue. Give your ad set a name, test ads. Then now this is where the magic happens. So instead of selecting the whole of Nigeria, since I have a tight budget, I am going to click on this place. Now if I click on this place, it has selected the whole of Nigeria. As you can see, it has selected the whole map of Nigeria, but my budget is tight. I cannot reach the whole of Nigeria, so I want to reach the people that are around me, so that if it means for us to meet physically, you know, people are more likely to buy your product if they can meet with you one on one. A lot of people prefer if they can meet you one on one than if they just pay money into your account. You know, if you only limit yourself to online, you may not be able to sell fast, especially if you are a new seller. Then I suggest that you only select people that are around you, so that if it means for you to meet them one on one, then they will now trust you more. So what I'm going to do is I am going to search for a location. Let's say I'm living in Awoyaya. I will type Awoyaya. No, I'm living in Lagos, Awoyaya. So I will type Lagos, Awoyaya. Okay, now Lagos, Awoyaya, Nigeria. So I'm going to select this. Okay, now as I have selected that, now you can see the radius. This is 40 kilometers around Awoyaya. I think depends on my budget. If that is what my budget can reach for now, I will limit myself to this area, so that the people that are going to be interested in my business will be people that are within this radius, so that if it means for us to meet physically, we will have to meet physically, and that way they will trust me more, because they will not have doubt that who is this person self. What if I give him money and I can no longer see him? But since we are within the same area, that means if they like, they can even come to my place and pay me cash. So that is how it is. Then you are going to select your age. You know, the age that you may select may be something like 30 and above. These are people that maybe have already graduated from university or polytechnic. These people may have money, but if you select people that are under the age of 18, 25, most of them are still in school, so they will not have much money. And you are also going to limit the limit, maybe something to like 50, because above 50 they are getting older, they may not be so much interested in new businesses. Alright, then having done that, then depends on the product you are selling, you can do the detailed targeting. let's say I am into real estate, so I'm going to browse here. I'll type real estate. Okay, now when you see real estate, there are so many of them that are here, so you will have to select the interest. That means the people that are going to targeting are real estate agents or people that are interested in properties. Then I'm going to click next, and after clicking next, then you are going to, I think other ones are what I've taught you in my previous videos. You can select your Instagram page, then you give your ad a name, you give your ad a name, then you will fix other things, which I believe you know all that now. If you have watched my previous video on how to run Facebook ad, okay, having done that, you are going to hit publish. Now when you publish this ad, this ad is going to run, and as it will be running, a lot of people that are interested in it will click and watch the video. Some people may not even click on it. Some will watch the video to 25%, some will watch it to 75%. Now as you have created this ad, then instantly you create another ad again. The second ad that you are going to create now, that is where you are going to target the people that have watched the video to a certain percent, or all the people that have watched the video. All right, now I show you how to create a custom audience of people that have watched your video to a certain percentage. Now if you have logged into your business manager, you are going to click on this hamburger icon, then you are going to go to audience. Okay, now when you go to audience, you are going to click on this create, then you will click on custom. Okay, now if you click on custom, you are going to select this video. Now if you select video, you are going to browse. If you click on this browse, you will see the first one here is people who viewed at least 3 seconds of your video, people who viewed at least 10 seconds of your video, and so on and so forth. You see people who have watched at least 25% means that this person is somehow interested, and these are the people that are really interested in your product, people that have watched the video to 95% or 75%. So depends on what you want to select. So you select, and you are going to type the number of days. You can leave it at 365 or leave it at 180 per 80 days, and you are going to give it a name. Let's say people who watched to 75%. Then I need to select the video. I need to choose the video. Then for me to choose the video, I'm going to select my page. I'm going to select my page. Then if I select my page, this is one of my video, so I'm going to check it. And if I check it, I'm going to hit confirm. Then I will now give it a name, and if you like, you can add description and hit create. I'm not going to create because I've already created that audience. I'm just doing this for your own sake. So you hit create and you are good to go. So when you are running your retargeting ad, this is the audience you are going to select. You are going to target them. This is where you are now going to sell your product to them. This is where you are going to sell your product to them. It means that those people that have watched the video to 75% or 50%, it means that they are interested in what you have to sell. These are people that may likely buy your product. And this retarget ad that you are going to run, you may leave it to run for some times. Don't, even though it's not converting, just allow it to be running, because most people do not buy your product the first day they see it. They have to see it over and over again before they make up their mind. And what you have to do is try as much as possible to always bring yourself in front of your audience. And this is what you do in retargeting ad. So you are going to target people that have watched the video. You also target people that have visited your landing page. You will target people that have opt-in, people that have subscribed to your email list. That is if you collect email list. Then you will also target people that have even bought your product. And the advantage of this is that if your products have served them very well and your ad is running before them, they may likely make comments that will validate your authenticity, that will validate that really you have served some people successfully. So that is one of the advantages of running your ad even before people that have bought your product before. Okay, I think having done all that, I think you are good to go. If you have any question as regards this video, don't hesitate to contact me. Thank you for watching this video, and see you again in the next video. Bye.